So things are warming up, you're in the heat of the moment, and crap! You're not on birth control and you don't have a condom. What do? In high school, I remember some of my friends saying something along the lines of, oh yeah, I hate condoms, just pull out. Well, you know, there are a couple of little problems with that. Cause first off, why are you hating on condoms? Condoms are pretty legit. When they're used properly, they can protect you against STIs, HIV, and pregnancy, all at once. How many other things in the world can do that? Yeah, like none. Using the pull-out method with a partner who hasn't been tested for STIs can expose you to STIs, even if you don't think that they have any. But it's seen as an alternative to condoms because, well, it's free, for one thing. And if you don't ejaculate inside your partner, then they obviously can't get pregnant, right? Wrong-ish. Here's the dish I'm pulling out. It actually can, in theory, provide you with some protection against pregnancy. When a couple uses the pull-out method 100% correctly every single time, 1 in 25 couples will get pregnant. That's about half as effective as using a condom properly every single time. But unfortunately, even that isn't what plays out in the real world. The actual number of couples that get pregnant with the pull-out method is closer to 1 in 3. I don't know about you, but those are not the type of odds that I want when it comes to accidentally getting pregnant. It's like reproductive Russian roulette. There are a few reasons why the pull-out method doesn't work so well in practice. The first is that pre-cum, which can come out before ejaculation, can contain sperm, which can get you pregnant. If you go pee before you have sex, that can help to flush sperm out, but even that isn't foolproof. The second problem is that if you pull out, if semen gets near the vulva, that can get you pregnant too. But the biggest biggie of all the biggies is that effectively pulling out requires a great amount of self-control. A lot of people with penises say they can do it, think they can do it, but when it comes down to those pivotal moments, it's actually a little harder than it might seem. It's pretty common for someone to partially or fully ejaculate on accident before they pull out, and that's why that big 1 in 3 number is there. To identify the exact moment that you need to pull out before you're going to ejaculate requires a lot of familiarity with your own sexual response cycle. They need to have experience with each other specifically, and they need to have a lot of trust in each other too. An accident could be a really, really stressful thing. And if you ever find yourself in that situation, Plan B is a good thing to try to get your hands on ASAP. So while using the pull-out method by itself isn't super great, it is a really great pair-up method. So pulling out when you use condoms, it's just gonna make whatever form of birth control you're already using that much more effective. And I guess it should go without saying that in the event that someone was going to have sex without a condom, either way, pulling out is better than not pulling out. If you're considering using the pull-out method, it's really important to make sure that you're both really comfortable with it. I have been pressured to use the pull-out method instead of condoms when I was younger. Not okay. I mean, it's my body and it's my health, damn it! I have every right and you have every right to feel comfortable and safe in every encounter. And so for me, that means that I am protecting myself against STIs and from pregnancy. And know that you can always pick up some male condoms at Planned Parenthood if you want to make your birth control that much more legit. So I hope that answered your questions about the pull-out method. If you have any more, feel free to leave them down below. We'll get at ya. Have a great week, everyone. I'll see you next time. Mwah!